From down below, from the inside out, it started somewhere.
Morning.
I'd like to welcome y'all this morning. Welcome, welcome, welcome in the house one more time. God did it again. He just keep on doing it again. Over and over and over again. No matter how we want it to go or what we gonna do, God is always in doing it over and over again. Be repetitious about his thing. We need to be repetitious about ours. Amen. Father God, we come to you this morning. Oh, in the name of your son, Jesus. Oh, Lord, our Savior, we thank you this morning that you saw fit to look down upon these old wretched rags.
Yes, Lord.
And wake us up.
Yes.
Clothing our right mind.
Yes.
With life.
Yes.
With health.
Yes.
And with strength, Lord God.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Can't nobody do it like you.
Right.
All power's in your hands. You do it all by yourself. We thank you this morning. We thank you for another day.
Yes,
that it was so beautiful this morning when we popped our eyes open. We were able to move.
Yes.
We were able to see.
Hallelujah.
And we could hear your voice say, rise, stand up, and be counted this morning.
Yes.
And Father, we thank you
thank you.
Another time that you blessed us with.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Father God, we know that we can only do this in the Spirit. In the Spirit and in truth.
Yes, Lord.
So, Father God, we're coming to you this morning asking you, Lord God,
fill us up
with that Holy Spirit,
yes,
that passeth all understanding,
yes,
Father God. Fill us up that we may worship and praise you this morning.
Hallelujah.
In spirit and in truth.
Yes.
And Father God, when all is said and done, Lord God, we ask that you touch this service this morning.
Yes, Lord.
Touch everyone present, everyone on Facebook live, Lord God.
Yes.
That you give us, Lord God, that thing that we need to worship you this morning.
Yes, Lord.
We ask that you touch the musicians, touch the song and phrase, touch your word this morning in your word bearer's mouth.
Yes.
And Lord God, let it be you. And not them, Lord God.
Yes.
And Father God, when we ask you, Lord God, for things that we need, Lord God, you already know it.
Yes.
So, Father God, we're going to give you the praise and give you the thanks ahead of time for what you already done, what you're doing right now, and what you're going to do in the next sessions of ministry, Lord God, today. Father God, it would be a great day, a great, great day for you to come down and heal us. But Lord God, in your time. So with that being said, Lord God, you don't show up right now and take us home. Lord God, we ask that we be busy about your business.
Yes,
that thy will be done and not ours.
Because
it's not about us, Lord God, it's about you.
Yes.
So Lord God, we thank you.
Yes.
In the matchless mighty name of your son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, Redeemer.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name, we ask you. Amen.
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 Yeah.
Thank you. I am Lord. Lord shall save me evening and morning, and at noon will I pray and cry aloud, and he shall hear my voice. He hath delivered my soul in peace from the battle that was against me, for there were many with me.
Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God, and the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus.
Yes. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem.
Yes.
They shall prosper that love thee. Peace be within thy walls and prosperity within thy palaces. For my brethren and companions' sake, I will now say, peace be within thee. Because of the house of the Lord my God, I will seek thy good.
Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law, which Moses my servant commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand, or to the left, that thou mayest prosper wheresoever thou goest. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success.
I am the vine, and ye are the branches. That abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, ye can do nothing.
I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me.
Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not into thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct thy path. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Father God, we thank you today. We humble ourselves before your almighty throne, oh God. Lord, we ask you to wash us and cleanse us, oh God, from all unrighteousness and iniquity, oh God. As we're in the presence of an awesome God, a holy God, a righteous God. We thank you. We thank you, Lord God. Bless these your people, oh God. Let them receive what they have come to give, oh Lord God. Let them be filled, Lord God, like never before. We thank you. Giving honor to our overseer, Pastor Britton, First Lady Britton, Elder Tate, all of the elders in the house, and all of those that are not with us today, not in the house today. Giving honor to each one of you. As I always say, you're valuable to the kingdom, each and every one of us. We're servants, so we're here to serve. Hallelujah. You know, I'm not a person who you all know like to get up in front of anyone. But I do it because I want to see what God can do through me.
Amen.
So I keep getting up here. But I tell you, I wrestled with the message to bring to you today. But I kept coming back to this. And so I'm being obedient, as I hope I always try to be.
Amen.
I'm bringing you this word today.
Yes,
Lord. I'm going to dive right in to the message. And also, I want to give honor to my husband.
Yes. Amen.
I tend not to say him because he doesn't like to be acknowledged, but I'm going to acknowledge him. As you see on the clock, there was a clock on the screen. And that clock is significant. The title of my message today is Go and Sin No More. And that clock is significant, because time keeps on ticking. Time keeps on ticking in rhythm, in sync. Regardless of what you do, it will not be disrupted. It will not stop. Time does not stop advancing. Regardless of where we are or what we're doing, time's gonna keep on ticking. Regardless of how much you've gotten done, time's gonna keep on ticking. Regardless of what you still need to accomplish, time's gonna keep on ticking. Regardless of what you believe about time, it's not changing. It's gonna keep on ticking.
That's right.
So we know that truth is not determined by what we believe, but by what he believes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In relation to time, I'd like to bring you these two stories. There are two instances in the New Testament where Jesus told someone, sin no more. And they're each very different circumstances. So first, John 5:5-14. It says, and I'm going to read it off my paper. The first is when Jesus healed an invalid at the pool of Bethesda. One man there had been an invalid for 38 years when Jesus saw him lying there and realized he had spent a long time in this condition. He asked him, "Do you want to get well?" "Sir," the invalid replied, "I have no one to help me into the pool when the water is stirred. While I am on my way, someone else goes in before me." Then Jesus told him, "Get up, pick up your mat, and walk." Immediately the man was made well, And he picked up his mat and began to walk. I'm going to jump down because this is not about the Sabbath. But if you know the story, of course, it's on the screen, that the man was made well because Jesus told him to pick up his mat and walk. When this man who told you, who was this man, Sadducees, the Pharisees, the religious leaders asked, who told you to pick it up and walk, they asked. But the man who was healed did not know who it was, for Jesus had slipped away while the crowd was there.
Amen.
Afterward, Jesus found the man at the temple and said to him, "See, you have been made well. Stop sinning, or something worse may happen to you." Then we go to John 8:6-11 for the other story.
Wow.
Teachers and Pharisees, the scripture says, or scribes and Pharisees, brought a woman caught in adultery to Jesus. And 6 says they were trying to trap him into saying something they could use against him. But Jesus stooped down and wrote in the dust with his finger. They kept demanding an answer, so he stood up again and said, "All right, but let the one who has never sinned throw the first stone." Then he stooped down again and wrote in the dust. When the accusers heard this, they slipped away one by one, beginning with the oldest, until only Jesus was left in the middle of the crowd with the woman. Then Jesus stood up again and said to the woman, "Where are your accusers? Didn't even one of them condemn you?" "No, Lord," she said. And Jesus said, "Neither do I. Go and sin no more." Hallelujah. Notice Jesus didn't pardon their sins. Nor did he say they were innocent. But he showed them mercy.
Yeah.
And he gave them another chance.
What?
See, that little word "go" should be priceless to a sinner and a saint.
Right.
Because it gives you hope. It means that the journey you're on, that you can go in a different direction. You can continue on, but go in a different direction.
Amen.
The little word "go" is powerful. The little word means you actively have breath to keep moving. You find grace in the going. Because you find an opportunity to still do.
Yeah.
You find you still have life in the word "go."
Oh,
proceed, in this case, in a different direction from the road you were going down.
Turn.
Repent.
Turn.
Don't take your sin any further. Don't take this baggage any further. Don't take the corruption in your mortal body any further. Don't drag it along. Hallelujah. It is clear that Jesus knew what caused the man's condition. It was originally sin that put him in this state. And it was sin that would only make it worse if he continued and didn't stop. Stop sinning or something worse will happen to you. This is true on every level, not just theirs. Jesus commands him to stop sinning. He commands her to stop sinning. Every time we decide to turn away from God and turn towards our own desires, which James tells us leads us astray, it's not God that tempts us. We open ourselves up to sickness, disaster, destruction, death, loss, suffering.
That's good.
To someone
that almost broke your little boy's heart, that sin that almost destroyed you. The ultimate worst which could happen is that you die in a sinful state and it cost you eternity with God. Hallelujah. If they return to their sinful behavior, if we return, we would have wasted an opportunity Jesus gave. Hallelujah. Yeah. To live a whole life. Yeah. To live a life that's forgiven. Now you can live a life in the fullness of its intent. Amen. Now you can live a life and truly flourish. Now you can bring him glory. Hallelujah. One day we'll cry out if we don't stop. No more.
Amen.
No more.
Amen.
Because this is what some of us will find ourselves saying.
Please,
no more, Father.
Please,
I can't take no more.
Amen.
Hebrews 12:6-11 says, because the Lord disciplines the ones he loves, he chastens everyone he accepts as his son. Hallelujah. They both should make better choices. We all must make better choices.
Amen.
With forgiveness comes the expectation that we will not continue in the same path of rebelliousness.
Yes.
Those who love God will naturally want to obey him.
Amen.
When we turn to Christ and receive his forgiveness, we experience a heart change.
Yes.
When we repent, we no longer are enticed, no longer desire the things that led us away from God. We desire God more.
Yes.
When we recognize the price of forgiveness, when we no longer live to please ourselves, we live out whatever pleases God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are all deserving of death for sin.
Yes,
but Jesus intervened to prevent that from happening.
Amen.
Not so we can continue in sin. He intervened for the woman caught in adultery. He intervened for the invalid.
Amen.
And he intervenes for us.
Amen.
He intervened when he went to the cross.
Yes.
At Calvary.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Romans 2:4 says, don't you know that the reason God is good to you is because he wants you to turn to him.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. The reason God is good to you is because he wants you to turn to him.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Sin no more.
Yeah.
Is a request or will of Jesus Christ that we should repent for our sins. Matthew 4:17, from that time on, Jesus began to preach, repent for the kingdom of heaven has come near. To follow Jesus Christ, we need to first repent from our sinful acts. Jesus requested the adulterous woman to stop her adulterous act. He requested that the invalid stop his sinful ways. She was about to be stoned to death, but Jesus rescued her with his divine wisdom. In return for this, Jesus requested them to not do the same sinful acts again.
Amen.
They both owe Jesus, just as we all do, for stepping in and not allowing us to receive what we stand guilty of receiving.
Amen.
There are grievous sins for which we need to repent after receiving forgiveness from Christ. We must not do the same sinful thing again and grieve Jesus. Going back to the sinful life is the same as crucifying him over and over and over and over and over again. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Time keeps on ticking.
It does.
Let me leave you with some powerful words that were given to me. It's in Numbers 32:23. But if you fail to keep your word, then you will have sinned against the Lord. And you may be sure that your sin will find you out. In the statement, "Be sure your sin will find you out," is revealed the mystery of sin. The nature of sin is such that whether or not others discover your sin will discover you. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
We cannot run from the consequences of sin. Sin carries with itself the power to pay the sinner back. And sin's payback is wrath. It's ultimate hell. Hallelujah. Amen. It's hell itself. When reading in the Greek, we see that God is timeless. Time is ticking onward.
Yes, it is.
Whether we pay it any attention or not, or keenly become aware of it or not,
yes,
use it wisely or not, yes, when the time comes for each of our journeys to be over, we cannot force that hand to strike not one more second.
Amen.
God is in control of time,
yes,
not man.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, I love the Apostle Paul.
Amen.
And I think of when he wrote his letters to the Corinthian church. And you know, the false teachers had come in. And Paul had to respond. He didn't want to respond because he had nothing to brag about. If he was going to brag, he was going to brag about God. He was going to brag about Jesus. He became low. He decreased, right?
Amen.
And Paul wasn't they wanted to ruin his reputation, right?
Yeah.
But what Paul wanted to protect the most was their loyalty to God and the truth of the gospel. He didn't want that stopped because he knew that if the truth of the gospel message was not going forward, then that meant they would go back out. And that meant they would not be prepared to meet the bridegroom.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So Paul saw himself just as us as leaders have to see ourselves as the one that's protecting the purity of the sheep. Protecting them so that when it is time, we can present the congregation, the sheep, to the bridegroom.
Amen.
We have to protect the innocence, the purity, the virginity,
yes,
of the congregation, of the body of Christ,
yes,
so that they're prepared and protected, so that when that father, that proud father, we in just as we saw Elder LaRonda get wedded, and we've seen many weddings, we see that father for a reason. We see that father walk that daughter down the aisle to give her to her husband. And God says, be prepared. Protect your purity. Protect your innocence.
Amen.
Because he wants to be presented a bride that is without spot or wrinkle. He will accept no other. We have to guard the salvation that we've been given. We have to guard it with purity of heart. We have to guard it so we can be presented to an awesome God on that day. We're betrothed to him. Paul wanted to protect that. He knew that he had given the people over to Christ. And he knew that until he returned, they had to walk before God holy and be presentable. So I want to tell you today, heed the words.
Amen.
Heed the words, go and sin no more.
Amen.
Because time is ticking,
mm-hmm,
and it is coming to a quick end. We are looking out into the world and seeing, we're hearing about death in so many ways every day. I know we don't think it's any of us, but that person who's no longer here never thought it was going to be them.
Right.
And they're gone.
Right.
So heed the words.
Yeah.
This is for me and this is for you.
Amen.
Go and sin no more.
Amen.
God loves you enough.
Amen.
That this is the message for today.
Amen.
It was the message for me.
Amen.
And it's the message for you.
Amen.
That time
is closing. And we have to stop. We have to stop. Put away those sins that so easily beset us.
Yeah.
Do away with those sins, whatever they may be. For the adulterous woman, for the invalid, it was their sins. But whatever the sin may be, we have to go and sin no more.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us all stand. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If Jesus did not show up in the first place, our faith, much like the invalid and the woman caught in adultery, would have been different.
Yes, Lord.
God is merciful. And we have all experienced this mercy and grace.
Yes.
He is loving. And we know this through the sacrifice of his son.
Yes, Lord.
But he is also holy.
Yes.
And this will not change. He wants us to get it right.
Get it right.
And he gave us a helper to assist us in achieving a righteous life.
Amen.
There is no one that has gone too far.
Amen.
There is no one that has done too much
Amen.
That cannot be saved.
Amen.
There is no one,
no one
that can out-sin God's love.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Either take the step to rededicate your life today.
Amen.
And don't look back.
Don't look back.
Hallelujah. I'm going to say it again. No one can out-sin God's love. No one. Today, salvation can come to you, so don't delay.
Amen.
Those of you in here, and those of you watching on Facebook, and eventually YouTube, there is nothing that can stop God from loving you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah. be a leader. Help him to be great. Give him traveling mercy as he goes that road. Bring him back safely, Father, with a testimony of all the great things we have done for him while he was at college.
To earth. I believe you are the Son of God,
yes,
who died on the cross for my sins,
yes, Lord,
and rose from the dead on the third day.
Jesus.
Thank you for bearing my sins and giving me the gift of eternal life.
Yes.
I believe your words are true. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus, and be my Savior. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We have any announcements for today? We have a visitor in the house? We have a visitor? Hello? No?
I've been coming here for a couple of months.
All right.
Amen.
Praise
Amen.
God. Praise God. Well, our announcements. The building fund, we've raised, as you can see, a blessing, because it all comes from him.
Yes.
And we ask that it continues to grow and to grow and to grow and beyond what we imagine or think, that Amen. That goal will be met.
Amen.
He can do it.
Yes, he can.
Won't he do it?
Won't he
do it? Hallelujah. Serenity Christian Fellowship yard sale, September 3rd, 2022. There'll be a $10 fish dinner. They'll be selling $10 fish dinners at 11 a.m. Fish, chips, bread, and drink. And that will be here at 1781 Art Museum Drive.
Amen.
Contact Elder LaRonda de Britton for more information. And then we have the adult Bible study. It says that we're going to be studying the 8th commandment, you shall not steal. And that will be on Zoom October 5th and 12th. And every Wednesday we meet on Zoom at 7 o'clock. So come and join us.
Amen.
Bring your voice, bring your pencils, bring your paper, and just join us and have a good time learning about the gospel of Jesus Christ. We have an anniversary.
Amen.
Happy anniversary to Deacon Larry and Sister Joyce Britton.
Amen.
August 1st.
Amen.
Hope they look good.
Amen.
And they blue. Happy anniversary to you. And that's it for announcements. God bless you and have a wonderful week.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Any takeaways before we dismiss?
My takeaway is that we've been given a gift of life, and we all know our condition prior to coming to God, and we want to make sure that we don't waste it, so we got to go and send them on.
Amen. Amen.
My takeaway is in the scripture when Jesus said, neither do I, as far as he doesn't condemn the woman that was caught in adultery. So it was just a reminder for me and should be for all of us to make sure that we're not condemning other people, whatever the sin may be, to make sure that we're not condemning, because God is not. Just give them the word and encouragement and not condemn.
Yes, yes. Hallelujah.
Amen. And I thank God for that. What was brought to my attention that dawns on me is that no matter what we're going through, no matter what sin we are committing, that God has mercy upon us and gives us the amount of time, not just to take us out or destroy us completely, but give us time to get it right, to turn from our wicked ways and our sins. And he said he'll heal the land. So that he gives life back to us. And that hope that we can. We can.
Amen. My takeaway was when the Lord said go, and he was iterating on how powerful just the word go is. And for me, you know, I get angry, but I think about the backdrop of the Lord's word when he said anger but sin not. So when I get angry, I have to think about that. I can think about that a lot, and I stop in my tracks. Also, that word go for me is when you say go, I think of a lot of people that do their sin and they get a second chance at life, and the word say go is freedom for them. Mm-hmm. And I thank the Lord, because I remember when I was in bondage, I was in the devil's bondage, and I didn't have freedom. But when the Lord came and he set me free and he said go, I received my freedom. And I thank him.
Amen. Amen. Well, if that's it, we can all stand to be dismissed.
Don't forget about offering.
Oh, okay. Thank you. That's important. We're now going to give an offering. Anyone who needs to see Sister Hughes, to please place your offering in the basket on your way out, or submit your tithes, your offering online.
Amen.
Using the Cash App, Serenity, $ Serenity Jax. Okay, all hearts clear?
Amen, man.
All right. You raise your hand. A child saved.
A child saved.
Is a soul saved.
Is a soul saved.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
You are dismissed.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.